Today we're talking about towing an RV with a half-ton truck. Now a lot of you guys are always asking us, what kind of truck are we using out on the road?
Yeah, we get a lot of questions about our truck.
When we say don't tow an RV with this, we're referring to our first truck that we ever purchased like almost 5 years ago. That was a half-ton, blue lifted, oversized truck with huge tires. And boy, were we in for some surprises with the financial mistakes that we were about to make.
Oopsies.
We're gonna get into that here shortly, but first let's set the record straight. This video is very specific to those looking to purchase a half ton truck. If you already own a half ton truck, this video is in no way meant to undermine your decisions, your lifestyle, or your specific situations leading up to your purchase.
Yeah, we love all sorts of trucks and tow vehicles out there, and whatever works for your lifestyle works.
We're just actually so happy that a lot of y'all are out here living life to the fullest through RV life already.
Yeah!
So talking about half-ton trucks specifically, or any trucks for that matter, is controversial. Oops. There's no right answers.
Yeah.
But our goal today is to tell our story in hopes that you can learn and have some objective points of view going forward in seeking out your purchase for the lifestyle you're looking for.
Don't make the mistakes we made.
Use the Hanks as an example of what not to do.
But without further ado, let's just get into our story and also introduce like who we are and what our channel is.
Totally, I'm Kyle.
I'm Renee.
And back in 2017, we started looking for an RV to live in.
Yeah.
While we pursue travel nursing.
Woo! We had no idea anything about trucks and tow ratings. We were just like, hey, here's a truck and it looks cool. Let's go buy an RV.
Yeah, literally we went and bought a truck thinking that it was gonna be able to tow anything.
Yep.
All the ratings such as gross vehicle weight rating or gross combined weight rating, curb weight, halo, that was all like foreign language to us.
Yes.
What are you talking about?
Yeah. There? And the half-ton truck that we had was kind of like, it looked like a monster, but it didn't tow like a monster.
Specifically, what happened is we pigeonholed ourselves into a corner with the truck that we initially purchased, being a half-ton.
And what we should have done was realized that we don't have enough truck for a lot of RVs out there. But what did we do? We just went, right, and bought an RV anyway.
Yeah.
That was suitable for that truck. Not much to work with.
Now, don't get us wrong. We're not saying you can't tow an RV with a half ton. I mean, obviously everyone is doing it. We did it initially. I'd say over half the people that have an RV have a half ton, and there's nothing wrong with that. What we're trying to enlighten you about is our backstory and where we went wrong with our purchases and how the half ton was not suitable towards our lifestyle. Basically, when we bought our first travel trailer, we bought a trailer that would put us at the max for that truck.
Yes.
Which is okay, but the problem was is we had other plans, and we're gonna get into those plans here shortly.
Not to mention our first travel assignment was in California, and we were leaving from Pennsylvania. So there was a lot of nerves about how will this gas half-ton truck do towing over so many mountains.
Yeah, we were going on like the Sierra Nevadas, the Appalachian Mountains. There were so many mountain passes. We're like, are we gonna hit bad weather on the way out? Like snow, ice. But at first they weren't running through the back of our minds. At first we were just like,
Whee!
Let's get a truck and let's get a trailer. So piggybacking on that topic of us making a rash decision to buy the half-ton truck, we wanna point out a couple questions that we wish we would've asked ourselves from the get-go that might help you when making your decision of buying a truck. First of all, think about what kind of RV are you going to be buying? Sure, maybe you're telling yourself, well, I know that. I'm gonna go buy a travel trailer. I'm gonna go buy a teardrop. Or are you even thinking about just buying a truck camper and throwing it in the back of your truck and hitting the road?
Even those can get really heavy.
Yeah, they really can.
You also have to take into consideration what type of RVing you're doing, meaning are you gonna be full-time, part-time? And if you're part-time or a weekend warrior, are you like hauling long trips and taking so much gear with you? Like, what are you gonna put in your truck? Also, if you're full time, you gotta plan that you're gonna be packing a lot of stuff to take with you to live on the road.
Do you guys have kids? Is there any concerns that your kids will graduate and then it's just gonna be you and your significant other and then maybe you'll go full time later on? Like, these are all questions that play into one another and you need to consider it from the get go rather than just playing, offense and just being like, yeah, we'll buy this and then we'll figure it out later.
Are you gonna be going to RV parks? Are you gonna be boondocking? And if you're not sure what boondocking is, it's basically the same thing as dry camping. You are not using any hookups. You are using the holding tanks, the onboard batteries, everything to power your RV. And if you are doing some boondocking, don't forget that extra batteries, generators, all the firewood, maybe all your cooking gear, that's gonna add up when it comes to weight in your truck.
Yeah, that's huge. And that's something we were like, well, we're gonna stay at RV parks along the way. But as we started full-timing, we're like, well, wait a second. We wanna start trying this boondocking because that looks cool too. So we didn't even consider that. So make sure you just keep an open mind about opportunities out there and maybe think about how a half-ton truck isn't gonna accomplish all those needs at one time.
It's also really expensive to constantly stay at RV parks.
Yeah, we're always boondocking, like doing boondockers welcome or trying to get off grid and just maybe taking a night here and there and staying in a parking lot or something.
Yeah, we don't do long-term boondocking, but just one night can save you like $50.
Yeah,
you know,
it adds up super quickly. Now, this is all tailored to your financial goals. We're not here to say what you can and cannot afford, but when we initially got started, we knew we were kind of on a budget and we had bought the half ton and we realized quickly that like, oh, I kind of wish we had gotten a little bit bigger. Mm-hmm. We're going to get into that in a second. But basically what we're saying is the RV life can be as expensive or it can be as cheap as you want it to be.
But let's get back to like the story of what happened with us and the truck purchases and...
You want to keep the spotlight on us.
Yes.
It's hot though. That spotlight is hot.
It is hot. That's Tennessee. So there we were. We had like 2 months till we were leaving for travel nursing. We had our truck, our half-ton Tonka truck, the RV that we just purchased. It was a Grand Design Imagine Travel Trailer 2150 RB, which is a really cool floor plan. So check that one out.
We liked it. It was like a 26 footer. It fitted our needs.
It worked. Did we want to go bigger? Yeah.
Yeah.
That's why we were stuck.
But why did we purchase a half ton? Like, that doesn't make sense. Why did we know we were eventually going to go bigger, but we purchased a half ton truck? It just...
Well, we just didn't know that, like, there was things about tow ratings. Like, we just assumed trucks could tow things back then.
And that's honestly was our first mistake, is we just assumed that was the way it is. And it just doesn't work like that.
The trusty YouTube and internet research had us really pondering, is this half-ton truck gonna get us to all of our destinations safely?
I'm sure it could have, right?
Well, it probably could have, but we were looking to make sure we had some wiggle room.
Yeah.
So one night, we were both at work in the ER. I'm pretty sure it was like 4 a.m. because we were night shift.
Yeah.
Kyle approaches me, AKA Carl, Kyle, whatever you wanna call him. He approaches me in the ER and he's like, hey.
I got a great idea.
And he was like, hear me out. There's this truck. Okay. It's like it's 600 miles away. No big deal. It's in Illinois. We're in Pennsylvania. But I love this truck.
Yeah, it was sweet. Had a lift kit. It's the one we're sitting on right now.
It's D.
It's D. And D stands for Denali, in case you're wondering, like, what does D mean? Basically, it's a 3/4 ton truck. And we're like, hey, babe, it's going to be overkill for what we have, the travel trailer.
Yeah.
And what could go wrong? We'll just go in, we'll drive, we'll turn in our truck, switch it out for this bad boy. It'll be overkill. We'll be handling all those roads and mountains perfectly. Nothing will go wrong, yada, yada.
So there we go. On our way to Illinois to go get this truck, and we're taking the old one with us. Our truck does have a 4-inch lift on it. D.
Currently.
You know, the old one, the half-ton Tonka truck, that had a 6-inch lift, right?
Yeah, and it just wasn't ideal for what we were looking for. Yeah. So, and I think that was another thing that distracted me is whether it's a half ton, 3/4, or 1 ton, I was looking at it more of like a visual, like, oh, what color do we like? Or what kind of size lift does it have? Does, you know, obviously this truck could handle that trailer at the time, but we were still chasing our own tails when it came to this. Where we initially went wrong is we took out negative equity on the current loan with the half ton and rolled it into this current truck.
Yeah, lots of debt.
We're rolling negative debt into a depreciating item like this truck. And it was just so stupid. So
D for debt.
D for debt, man. We were like, what are we doing? So we bought the truck. We bought D. We're super happy with it. We go along on our way, couple years living in that travel trailer. Loving life. It's handling it like a pro. Yeah, what could go wrong?
Well, Nene needed more space.
Yeah.
Is what went wrong.
Are you sure it wasn't Dexter, our cat?
Probably.
Probably.
Currently, we have a 2019 Grand Design Solitude S-Class 2930RL.
And what did we do? We made the exact same mistake. Now we have a truck that was overkill for the travel trailer. We're buying a fifth wheel tailored to this truck. So now we're
pigeonholed again.
We're pigeonholed again, and we're maxed out again. So if we ever wanted to upgrade from our current living situation, we have to go buy another truck. That would be like, what do they say? Like,
third time's a charm.
I hope. Goodness, with this Hanks family, with the way we're rolling with things, I don't know if there's any charm in it at all.
I just don't know if you ever want to give up, D.
If we ever have a family and we want to start raising kids on the road, we're not going to be able to live in this forever. We might need something a little bit bigger. And unfortunately, D cannot handle that. So that is, hey, look it. I'm not just hating on half tons. I'm not just hating on 3/4 tons. I'm just saying find something that's going to be sustainable throughout all your RV travels.
And it's not that we're talking bad about our current RV. We love our fifth wheel. And when we purchased it, it was still an upgrade. We went from 27-foot travel trailer to about 34, 35-foot.
Mm-hmm.
It is the smallest of the Solitude lines from Grand Design, but I'm telling you, like, it's huge inside. And we were just like, whoa.
Yeah, for sure. And we're concerned not expressing, you deserve to at least hear our side of the story, because we don't want you to get out there and have the same issues where you're like, well, I want to upgrade now.
Because we get emails from you guys where you're kind of in the same situation. You're not sure if you could, if you should upgrade the current truck you have to something bigger. And you guys will say, what do you have? And what truck do you have? And it's like, we tell you what we have, but if we did it again, we would probably just have gone with the 1-ton truck. But that's a personal preference. You guys might not be RVing as long as we do. Maybe you just want to do it short term, and maybe you do want a smaller RV so you can get into all the nooks and crannies of the country.
You were thinking, like, we should have went with the 1-ton right off the get-go, right? So that we would cover our bases throughout, whether we have a small travel trailer or teardrop or, like, a big toy hauler. We could have hauled it all. Buy one truck that fits all your needs, right?
We love when we're walking around the RV park and we see like a teardrop trailer and then like a 1-ton truck, and we're just like, ooh, are you sure you can pull that?
Are you sure you can pull that? But they're like, joke's on you. I could pull anything I want. So I'm going to be able to pull this and then go upgrade and pull anything I want. And unfortunately, with a 1/2-ton truck, you're not left with much wiggle room at all.
No.
And that's up for debate. But from our experience in all of our research over 5 years of full-time RV living, we've heard, met a lot of people, heard a lot of stories, and what we've heard is there's not much wiggle room. So
yeah, and we know lots of people who started in a 1/2-ton, just like we did, and then they were like sending us pictures like, surprise, we got a bigger truck. Like they upgraded to a 3/4-ton.
And we're
like, hey, why does everybody do this?
Right, why do we do this? We personally feel like it's better to over-truck your trailer than over-trailer your truck. Basically saying, buy a bigger truck that can handle everything rather than just buying a truck and then matching that trailer to the truck.
Yeah.
Because if not, you're going to do this whole like stair-stepping game and you're just going to be blowing money out your butt.
Exactly what we did. With the current inflated economy, you're already paying out the butt for a new truck.
That's so true. Yeah. It really is. Everything's jacked up in prices. And if you're already looking to purchase in this market, unfortunately, you're already behind the game. So make one purchase that's going to fit all the needs. So if we would suggest anything, is if you have any potential to go back and answer those questions, and those aren't subject to change, like your lifestyle may go full time eventually, or the kids may grow up and you and your significant other might want to do more traveling, we would suggest on buying a bigger truck, especially in this economy.
With a larger truck, not only do you have the benefit of increased tow capacity, but you have things like increased fuel capacity, because aren't the tanks much bigger on some of the bigger trucks?
Yeah, that's a great point. Like, you won't have to stop as much to fuel up, which is really nice and convenient during your travels.
That's really nice. And you also have the benefit of not having that negative equity if you're constantly, like, buying a truck and having to upgrade and having to upgrade again.
Like we did.
And I think we don't do a 3,500. We don't do a 4,500. We get a 5,500.
Wow, those are huge.
Let's just go really big.
Do you see what I have to deal with here? This is So all in all, this is peace of mind. If you buy a bigger truck, you can handle anything from the smallest loads to the heaviest tows.
Ooh,
I mean, that's cool, huh?
I love
and
that.
It rhymes.
That was, you didn't just, you just came up with that, didn't
just
you?
Just off the top of my little head here. make sure you subscribe because we have new videos every single week. Much love to you all. We'll see you next week.
Bye, guys.
Later.